Well, we're back again. Ray Birmingham, Thunderbird Field. Game four on the weekend. Second one today. T-Birds up 3-0 in the series on the weekend against the Clarendon Bulldogs here. And so far, so good. 10-4 win in game one today for the Thunderbirds. They won each of the first two as well in this series. Yesterday, 21-2 and 19-0. Just a 50-6 weekend. 56. There we go. I'm going to figure this out. Mathematically challenged as I am. Dusty Windham here with you for game four in a cold, but a little bit drizzly now game. The lights on at the field here at Ray Birmingham Thunderbird Field. And tell you what, man, this, again, the first time I've seen lights actually working here at the field ever. So it's pretty nice. The light poles just went up about a month ago here at the Ray. And the T-Birds now ready to close out this weekend set against the Clarendon Bulldogs. On the bump for the T-Birds, let's see. We have number 24 for your Thunderbirds on the bump here. And I am pretty sure that is my buddy. And it is Isaiah Arteaga. Arteaga ready to deal here. And it will be the center fielder and the leadoff man at the plate here. Brownlee for Clarendon to start off this nine-inning affair, which cannot possibly last longer than the seven-inning affair did earlier. It just seems long because of the cold. First pitch from Arteaga is across for a strike on the swing and miss. As I get my scorebook back up. Gotta love apps in a phone. You know, you used to have to write all this stuff down. Now it's just a thumb. Little stoppage and play there. And I wouldn't even call it a drizzle, more like a mist coming in here. A miss from Arteaga on the off-speed pitch, and here we go. 1-1 count as we're in the top half of the first inning in the final game of the weekend series. And this one swung on, fouled down the right side. And it'll be 1-2. There's the 1-2, just missing outside, perhaps a bit low. Buck behind the dish, lock on Mod Innit catcher in game number two today. DH'd in game one, had a pretty good game. And now we'll be behind the plate here. Get that fixed up. And Brownlee looking at a 2-2. Arteaga will deliver. Oof. Didn't get the call there, and it'll be a full count. And we're back in action. Full count. Leadoff man for the ball game here. And Brownlee will hit it over to short. Urias up with it. Across with a strong throw to Arroyos. And there's one away here in the first.
Now betting is a right fielder, number 30.
So Malish will come to the plate here for this Bulldog team. It's dropped its first three conference games here to your Thunderbirds. And here we go. Arteaga's first pitch swung on and driven out into right. A long way to go. But the play made by Hoffman out in. Oh, he dropped the ball. He dropped the ball. They still call him out and say it was on the transfer. So, yeah, they called the out there. I guess he lost the ball on the transfer. So there's two away. It's the only thing I can think of that they would have called here. And Arteaga's got two down here in the first, and blows one by Fernandez there. So the 0-1 on its way. And this one's popped up towards the right side. It's on the infield, though. Looks like Arroyos is calling it and got a long way to go and catches it with room to spare. And it's a 1-2-3 inning for Arteaga as we get started here in the final game of the weekend. T-Birds will be up to bat in the bottom half of the first when we come back. Back here at Ray Birmingham, Thunderbird Field. Bottom half of the first inning of game number two on the day. The fourth of the weekend set against these Clarendon Bulldogs. T-Birds winning 21-2, 19-0, and now 10-4 in today's opener. And they'll look to close out the series with a sweep here against Clarendon. Pitcher for the Bulldogs in game number four here is going to be Mr. Bell. I didn't say Mr. Bill. I said Mr. Bell. Yeah. For those of you who are listening, watching. Thanks for joining us again. New Mexico Junior College provides this service. Keep the friends and family of their student athletes involved and able to follow their athletic moments out here on the field. And it will be Urias to start it off as usual. The leadoff man and shortstop for the T-Birds will go against Miller Bell. Bell is 6'3" righty out of Brisbane, Australia. First pitch, not close. Gets through the catcher as well, and it'll be a 1-0 count here. So Bell gets that one across for a strike. Good pitch. A little fastball and catches the outside part of the plate here to the right-handed hitting Urias as that miss continues to just kind of hang around. Wind is blowing in from center here at Ray Birmingham Thunderbird Field. 2-1 as that one will go up high. See if we can finish off this weekend set here with a dub. As that one is fouled right back. Oh! Tell you what, got him on the inside thigh. We'll just say that. That's a tough spot to get him. And he's going to take a second to walk that one off. I would too. So that foul catches the thigh here. It's Montos still in the lineup at catcher. Man, he's had a tough day back there. He's taking a bat on a backswing to the helmet. Let's see, he's been hit with a couple of those tips there, and the umpire now getting a chuckle out of that one. As we're back to action, 2-2 is the count off the foul tip that seemed really foul to Montos. as we go 2-2. You couldn't hit one higher than Urias just did. And sliding in was the third baseman. He didn't make the play. It was Oviedo, who is in the lineup today.
As number 11, Brent Iredell.
Iredell will come to the plate. It was Matos who made the play, kind of getting Urias back for that tip, I guess. So there you go. That ball in play. First out of the first inning for the T-Birds here, as Iredell will step up to swing the sticks. First pitch swinging off of Bell is Iredell, and he'll pop it foul to the other side. Two of the men from the land down under doing battle here. Righty-righty matchup. And Bell will deal. This ball hit over to third. Oviedo is up with it for this Bulldog team. Gets it across to first. And that's going to be Reed at first in this game, it looks like. Number 7 it is. And there's two away here for the T-Birds in the bottom half of the first. We're still scoreless here. T-Birds won the opener 10-4 today. Have outscored the Bulldogs 50-6 on the weekend. As Lena Royals will check in. Up high and outside with the offering is Bell on this one. It's a 1-0 count here. Swing and a miss from Arroyos that time on a fastball. Pops out of Matos' glove, but it will be thrown back out to Bell. So a couple of the T-Bird players up with the radar gun coming in to check some stuff out. That one outside from Bell. Make it a 2-2 count, or a 2-1 count, excuse me. As it's first time all season I've seen him set up like this. There's the pitch. It's going to be just out. Bit low as well. 3-1 count here for Bell against Arroyos. Are you qualified to operate that thing, sir? So, still just a bit wet, not too bad out here. As it's almost fog-like here, as the pitch misses again. That'll be a walk on 5 pitches issued to Arroyos, and we'll go back to Jonathan Cloak. So, T-Birds have a runner on with 2 outs here in the first inning, and it'll be close at the bat by Ania on deck for these Thunderbirds. This one will bounce from Bell. Stopped by Matos and thrown back out. A 1-0 count here. T-Birds off to a great start yesterday with the 21-2 and 19-0 victories. Wish they'd have saved those run rules for today. Could have got us home early. Screen getting wiped there because we have the best technical crew in the history of the world here at New Mexico Junior College. As the lens getting wet here from time to time in the humid weather. 1-1 count now here as that's a ball called. I thought it was pretty close. Not quite the strike we thought. And now this one is across for a strike. Almost same pitch, I thought. So So it will be Bell to look. He'll take a peek at Arroyos at first. And on the 2-2, come to the plate, swing and miss, close strikes out to end the inning. So through one, we're scoreless here in the final game of the weekend. We'll be back in a moment. Back here at Ray Birmingham Thunderbird Field, or the Ray as we're calling it right now. I'm Dusty Windham, freezing, sniveling. Everything else you could say that you are doing, I am doing. So, through one, T-Birds and Bulldogs are scoreless. T-Birds again have outscored the Bulldogs 50-6 on the weekend. And looking to continue that dominance is Isaiah Arteaga out on the bump here for game four. Arroyos reached base on a walk in the bottom half of the first for the T-Birds. He was stranded. And that's where we're at. Let's see where we are at here. It will be Stephen Courtney coming to the plate. He's playing DH in this one. Was at first in game one today. Now this ball is hit straight up. Hoffman out and right will get under it, settle in, and he'll squeeze it, make the play. And there's one away early. Top half of the second, still scoreless. If you're just joining us. So we got a new one out here. Rui Yoshida's the second baseman. Had a pretty good game. Two for four in game one today. Now we'll look. Arteaga up high to him, and it'll be a ball. And the second pitch just misses that time for a ball as well. So 2-0 count here, one away in the top of the second. Strike called this time. Not liking the call is Yoshida, but he'll step back in. Wow, that's a called ball there too. That does look pretty good from here, but a 3-1 count now. So Yoshida now, take the 3-1, he'll pop it towards the right side, picked up over at second, throw made across in time here to retire Yoshida. Two away now here in the second.
Now batting the first base, number 7, Reed.
So it'll be Aubrey Reed coming to the plate here, playing first base in this one. Hitting from the right side. And, whew. Just not getting the call there again. 1-0 count. Looked like it was across the plate from here, but that's why I'm up here announcing and not calling balls and strikes. Arteaga missing again. A 2-0 count here to start off to Reed. again, T-Birds improved to 7-2 in conference play. Or shoot, I said 7-2. That's not true. They're 4-2, 5-2 in conference play in their seven contests so far. And we'll look to continue that. A sweep here today would be big for the T-Birds as the conference slate doesn't get any easier from here. That one fouled back by Reed, and now the count evened up at 2-2. Arteaga taking his time here on this one. Now to the plate, up high. Might have overthrown it just a bit that time. And it's a full count, 3-2. T-Birds a strike away from being able to come back into the dugout and swing the bats for a moment. Still scoreless here, top half of the second inning. And now this ball hit over towards first. Arroyo smothers it, gets up, tags first, and unassisted. Gets the T-Birds out of the inning. So, nothing doing for the Bulldogs so far. We'll head to the bottom half of the second with the T-Birds and Bulldogs tied at 0. We'll be right back. Back again here at the Ray. Ray Birmingham, Thunderbird Field, T-Birds and Bulldogs still doing battle here in the final game of this four-game set in conference play. T-Birds have taken the first three after splitting a series in Roswell against New Mexico Military last weekend. Seemed to be feeling a little bit better. It seems like the T-Bird bats have started to find a rhythm here over the weekend, scoring 21, 19, and 10 so far in double figures every game. Pitching has looked solid so far, only giving up 6 runs in 3 games here against Clarendon College. T-Birds will send Bionia to the plate first here in the second. The pitch from Bell outside for a ball. Now a swing and a miss from Bionia, who struggled in game one. 3 strikeouts and a pop-up in earlier action today. 1-1 count here. As Bionia will watch that one come in low for a ball. 2-1 to Eric now. Bionia holds up on that one. And, see what the ump throws up. got a 2-2 count here. He did not hold up, according to the field umpire there. So the 2-2 on its way. Fouled off by Bionia. He'll stay alive here and get another look. That one catches Bionia in the arm.
Now batting is the right fielder, number 15, Christian Hoffman.
And Hoffman will get a chance to hit with a runner on. Nobody out here in the bottom half of inning number two. It's the first time today that Bionia has reached base. And his speed can make a difference out on the path. And now Bionia goes. Hoffman's able to get into this one a bit. It's carrying. And with the wind blowing in, this one will still go off the wall. And on his horse is Hoffman. He's going to get at least the third. They'll hold him there as the throw comes in and is cut off by the pitcher, Bell. Bionia scores from first. And it's a 1-0 lead for your Thunderbirds here in the second. That'll bring up Lachlan Maud again here for the T-Birds. So a triple off the bat of Hoffman, and even with the wind blowing in, which is rare here at the ballpark here at New Mexico Junior College, that was a shot, man. If that had been hit yesterday, it'd have gone 450 feet. This one popped up by Maud in shallow center, and somehow coming up for it is Brownlee and throws another grounder in. And gets it home before
Darren Foster.
Any movement from Hoffman at third. He's probably still breathing hard as Christian over at third. I don't know how many triples he's had in the last 2 years, but not that many. That'll bring up Jaron Foster in the game here. And Bell will deal here. One away. With a runner at third for Foster. That one bounces. Matos able to keep it in front of him this time. And Foster will get ready to get back in the box here. The first time we've seen Foster today. And he'll take a ball there. 2-0 now from Bell to Foster. Swing and a miss on that off speed offering, and it's 2-1. Again, it's Hoffman at third after the RBI triple off the wall. And, catches the corner, I guess. So, 2-2 now to Foster. It was close. Looked a little outside from my perspective. But then I got that angle, you know. We've talked about it. 2-2. That one caught more of the plate, but it looked a little low. That is the call, and it's a full count now to Jaron Foster. Again, in the bottom half of the second inning, final game of this set, and Foster holds up on that one, draws a walk, and we'll have runners on the corners here with one away. So Pepe Contreras will come to the plate here for the T-Birds. Playing over at second base this afternoon. Foster, 6 foot six, long stride, but back to the bag as they tried to keep him honest over there. T-Birds have run a lot more this season than they did last season, a little less pop in the bats as a whole and a lot more speed on the base paths and willingness to go. Coach Robbins and Coach Laurel Felix sending these runners a little more often. This one's hit the opposite way. It's going to hang up a long time, end up foul, and bouncing in the bullpen area of the Bulldogs down the right field side. So everybody back to their stations, and we'll try it again. So again, the 0-1 coming to Contreras here. Foster at first. It is Hoffman at third, and this one's popped up to shallow right. They'll settle under it. They will make the play. The throw coming in a little strong this time, and right on the money to Matos, keeping Hoffman at third. So runners will stay put, and now two away here. As the leadoff man, shortstop Luis Urias, will come to the plate. So, Bell looking to get out of this inning has had a pretty decent first couple of runs through the lineup here. T-Birds do lead at 1-0. And the T-Birds still up with runners on the corners with two outs here in the second. That's a pretty pitch. Bends right across the plate, and it'll be an 0-2 count here to Urias. And this one will bounce. It'll be a ball, and 1-2 now your count here. Foster's just going to take off before that. Now we've got a balk. That'll score a run here as Bell just all kinds of fooled on that one. 2-0 T-Birds. As Hoffman comes across the plate. And a good start again for New Mexico Junior College. This ball fouled off towards the left side this time. Yeah. As far as I know. That I don't know. My brain has frozen now, Holly. I'll tell you that. So the throw to Urias now. Another foul back. This time it'll hit him and not the catcher. He'll walk that off and get ready for the 0-2. And the 0-2 is going to be low and in from Bell for a 1-2 count here. Still have a runner at second base due to T-Birds. Two down here in the bottom half of the second. They're up 2-0 over Clarendon. Try it again. The 1-2 on its way. Just missing that time, and we're evened out at 2 balls and 2 strikes. It's cool. Gotta say it, man. These fans are dedicated out here today, no doubt. That one's going to bend back across, catch the inside part of the plate, and it'll put Urias down on strikes there to end the inning. But the T-Birds do strike twice, and they lead it 2-0 as we head to the third. All right, we're going to be back again here for the third inning. As T-Birds have taken a 2-0 lead after scoring a couple there in the bottom half of the second. One on a triple by Hoffman, the other on a balk. And now lead it 2-0 over the Bulldogs. T-Birds took the first three games of the set, up to 5-2 in conference play on the season.
Third base, number 11, Oviedo.
So we will have number 11, and that's Oviedo coming to the plate here. We're playing over at third in this contest. As Arteaga will step back up on the rubber here for the T-Birds. This ball, first pitch swinging, it'll get through the hole. Between third and short under the glove of Iredell, and a leadoff single here for Oviedo.
Now batting as a catcher, number 5, Matos.
So Daniel Oviedo leads off the third with a base knock for Clarendon. And now first pitch swinging again, a little slow roller towards the pitcher. Arroyo's able to get a piece of the bag on the throw that was just off from Arteaga, but they're able to record the out. Over to second is Oviedo. And now a foul ball by Menchaca, this shortstop here, to bring the count to 0-1. Runner at second and one away. We're in the top half of the third. And Arteaga will deal here. Righty will get another foul ball off of Menchaca, and it'll be 0-2. So Arteaga now with the 0-2 to Menchaca. Swing and a miss on the high fastball, and just blew it by him that time. Two down here now in the third.
Number 14, Browning.
So the center fielder, Brownlee, tough afternoon for him. The big error out there dropping the fly ball in center field earlier, and then a couple of tougher plays. There's the pickoff attempt there by Arteaga. Got to keep those throws down this year on the middle infield. Neither guy over like 5'6", I think, out there. Is that about right? Yeah. So Brownlee back in. And Arteaga deals. This one fouled straight back, and it'll be 0-1. The 0-1 is going to be up, and a called ball here, 1-1 the count to Brownlee. This ball swung on, it's hit over to short, a sliding stop there for Uriasi. He'll throw to second trying to get the runner. A little bit late as he's back in is Oviedo, and well, two on and two out now for the Bulldogs. That'll bring in Malish, the right fielder here. With two down and runners at first and second. That one a called ball there from Arteaga. So that one also a ball, 2-0 the count here as Arteaga falls behind in the count. He'll check the runner at second. Nobody holding the runner there with two down. Swing and miss that time from Malish as he probably got something he wanted there. A little fastball up in the zone. And Arteaga now with a 2-1 pitch. Again, runners at first and second with two down here in the top half of the third for Clarendon. They trail your T-Birds 2-0. That one inside, and it's a 3-1 count now. So, Arteaga will He thought about it a bit, comes to the plate that time. It's chopped over to Contreras at second, over to Arroyos, and that'll end the inning here. T-Birds get out of it without allowing a run still. And they lead it 2-0 as we head to the bottom half of the third. We'll be back in a few moments. Back here for inning number three, the bottom half of it anyways, the home half. And first pitch swinging is Iredale off of Bell. He pops it up out into left center. Play made by Brownlee out in center. And there's one away in the third. Luke, if you want to know if it's brutal out here, you're absolutely correct. Yes, it is. Yes, yes, it is. Holly Reyna agrees with me, women's volleyball coach here at NMJC. We've decided that the T-Birds should have saved their run rules for today, Luke, is what's happened. So, Bell will deal here to Arroyos. That's a called strike. Catches the inside part of the plate. And the 0-1 outside this time. 1-1 to Elaine Arroyos. T-Bird first baseman's had a good weekend here against Clarendon. He gets all of that one. It's going to go foul down the right side, but I tell you what, he hit that one 380 at least. So a 1-2 count now to Arroyos. Let's see, Luke, currently 44 degrees here at the ballpark with a 12-mile-an-hour wind. Good pitch that time, called a ball. They thought it was strike three, did Matos and Bell each, but it's going to be a 2-2 count here. The wind chill just down to 37, though. Not too bad. Not too bad. Bit misty, as you could tell, if you're watching the game here, as the screen or your screen will show how the camera lens is catching some of this mist out here. 3-2 count now as they've worked the count full to Arroyos. And that's going to be ball four there. And Arroyos down 0-2 in the count. Works a walk here. And that'll bring up Jonathan Clope. And now Arroyos with a decent leadoff over at first. Clope 0-for-1 with a strikeout in the game. That one does not catch the inside part of the plate that time. It was close from Bell, but Arroyos has walked twice now in this contest. We're in the bottom half of inning number three. 2-0 T-Bird lead off of a Hoffman triple that drove one in and a balk that scored Hoffman. 2-0 has gone Bell to Clough here to start this AB. Miller Bell will try to find the plate here. He does on the off-speed pitch. It bends back across and a swing and a miss that time from Clough. 2-1 your count here with one away in the bottom half of inning number three. I will tell Luke, hey man, the lights look good out here though. I'll say that. It's kind of different to see them here on the Ray Birmingham Thunderbird Field fence lines out here, but that's going to be a strike as unable to hold up was Clough on that check swing. And now 2-2 with one away. Arroyos at first here for the Thunderbirds. And there is an arm up in the bullpen over here for New Mexico Junior College. Oof. Just missing and a better eye than I have as Clough took that one. And the count now full again. T-Birds winning 21-2, 19-0, and then 10-4 in the opener of today's action. So a 3-0 weekend so far for New Mexico Junior College and head coach Mike Robbins. Arroyos goes on the 3-2. That one's ball four. And now two on. With just, I don't even know how to fix that one. It'll be all right. You could just leave it up there. I'd just leave it up there. Mike Robbins coming out to speak with his player at second base, Elena Royos, and the field umpire as well. T-Birds have runners at first and second after the walk to close. And it will be Eric Bayania stepping up. Just to be clear, there's only one out here at the ballpark here in the third inning. Runners at first and second with one away. As Bayania thought about it, holds up and takes a ball on the curveball inside. Bayania, three strikeouts and a sac fly in his first game today. He walked his first time up in this one. Runner still at first and second. Not much of a lead either bag, and a swing and a miss by Bayania there, and it's evened up at a ball and a strike. So Bell will look in, get his signal. They'll set up outside. Will the catcher Matos here. And the righty delivers. That one back in and gets across the inside part of the plate to Bayania again. 1-2. Runner staying put so far with Arroyos at second, Clough at first. Clough, one that likes to go. Got some wheels. Dances a bit when he's not behind somebody else on base. Bayania strikes out for the fourth time today on that pitch. Swing and a miss, and it'll be Christian Hoffman now coming up to the plate with two outs. See, I told you you'd be right very soon. Right there. There it is. So the strikeout swinging there. Again, the fourth of the day for Bayania. And I think they were all on breaking balls. Two on, two out for the T-Birds here in the bottom half of the third as Hoffman steps in. Miller Bell trying to work his way through this third inning and get out without any more damage. The 1-0 coming here to Hoffman. Big lead at second now for Arroyos with nobody holding him. That ball up and outside for ball two. 2-0. Lacamotte awaiting his chance to hit. He's on deck. Should Hoffman reach here and have another chance to drive in a run. He's had a good weekend himself. Not only on the field, but his family here making a long trip down from Canada to come down to southeastern New Mexico and watch the action. And so glad they did. Got to talk to them a little bit. And very, very cool people, man. T-Birds are big on bringing in high-character individuals. They have done so, and that young man as well. Strike on the outside part of the plate on the 3-0 pitch to Hoffman. Taking the whole way there. And now Miller Bell will try to get out of the inning. 3-1 count to Christian Hoffman. There are two outs here and runners at first and second for the T-Birds. Full count now as the off-speed pitch catches the outside part of the plate and Hoffman will step back in. Payoff pitch coming here, and we've got a Mike. I think Cole may have an issue there with some cramps, perhaps, as he's back to second base and a timeout called. As Lauro Felix and also, that's Arroyos, excuse me, over at first. Or at second, close at first. So I said it backwards, but so it looks like it could be cramps for Arroyos there. He's reaching down towards the calf area. And they'd already come out once, so they'll bring the trainer out for a moment here to check on him. T-Birds lead it 2-0. We're in the bottom half of third. There is a full count to Christian Hoffman with two on and two out here. Chloe actually hustles, gets the spray from the trainer, I believe, and out there to try to relieve the cramps. We're going to take a quick break, and we'll be back in a moment with more T-Bird baseball. Unable to work the cramps out there for Arroyos, it looks like, and hopefully that's all it is a cramp. It does appear that way. But he's going to come off the field. Travis Vlasic will come in to run for him. And now the knee bending a little bit more. But, man, I tell you, I can remember those days. And yeah, he's got his left leg pretty locked up there with the cramps. And they'll get him off the field here as Arroyos will be checked out by the finest training staff in junior college sports. Again, a 2-0 lead for the T-Birds in the bottom half of this third inning. A 3-2 count to Hoffman as he'll step back in with two runners on. Hoffman swings, hits one out towards right field. This thing is carrying a ways, but will hold up before the warning track and be caught out there in right by Clarendon College. So a 2-0 game as we head into inning number four in the final of this four-game set. We'll be back in a few more minutes with more T-Bird baseball. All right, we're back here for the top half of the fourth inning, live from Ray Birmingham Thunderbird Field on the campus of New Mexico Junior College, right here in Hobbs, New Mexico. Let's see if we have a new first baseman. I'm sure we probably do, as I see, it is Vlasic out at first now for these Thunderbirds, as Arroyos has gotten some attention from the trainers on what looked like some cramps down in the lower leg in the calf area. Arteaga back out on the mound. Hasn't allowed a run yet in this one, as it'll be Christian Fernandez coming to the plate here. 0-for-1 today. Popped up to, well, Arroyos in foul territory. His first time up. Arteaga sees that one go sky high, might have a big bang this time. That was a little bang. Didn't sound too loud as it goes off the overhang here. Or the roof of the bleachers, if you will. 0-1 count here. Arteaga up high with that fastball, and it'll be a 1-1 count. Into the fourth inning of this final game of this four-game set that we've had this weekend against Clarendon College, making the trip down to Hobbs. And yesterday, beautiful. Just 80 degrees, blue skies, little breeze here and there, and T-Birds responded well. Bats breaking out for 40 runs in those two games yesterday, 10 more in the third. Now two here in this fourth game of the set. Total of 52-6 so far on the weekend. Way up high and even over the mitt of Maud behind the dish here. It's a 2-2 count here. Fernandez leading off this fourth inning for Clarendon College. Behind him, it looks like Stephen Courtney will be on deck. And then Yoshida in the hole. This one's fouled off towards the right side out of play, and we'll get another look at a 2-2. Arteaga got 32 pitches now. Let's see, 33, excuse me, as we're into the fourth inning. But he's been very efficient so far in the game and has only allowed a couple of knocks so far. Arteaga. Just a bit high that time to Fernandez, and we'll have a full count here with nobody out in the fourth. T-Bird still leading 2-0. We're about an hour into this one, 56 minutes, if you will. I said I just checked that out on this app. It does that for us, too. Once they say play ball, it keeps track of the time. Either way, ball hit out to fairly deep center field. Chloe is able to run it down off the bat of Fernandez, and there's one away.
Now batting as a designated hitter, number 16, Courtney.
It will be the DH, Stephen Courtney, coming to the plate here for Clarendon College with one away in the fourth. And first pitch from Arteaga will miss for ball one. So you know it's cold when your fingers are too cold to touch your touch screen and it do anything for you. Now this one's hit out and right, it's going to be foul and a long ways. Does get out of play over the wall out in foul territory, and it'll be a 1-1 count here. T-Birds do have a righty up in the bullpen, warming up a bit with this cold weather. I almost feel like I wish I was warming up out there. Not that anybody wants to see me play. What a play out at second. Pepe Contreras on a ball that was booped right over second baseman's head. He wheels back, takes a couple of steps on his way back, just kind of on his heels, turns and leaps, makes a great leaping catch for the second out of the inning. Rui Yoshida, up to the plate now. Just a fantastic play out there by Contreras. Oh, 1 after the first pitch from Arteaga here. That one will get past Maud behind the dish as it was low and out. And we'll get a 1-1 count. I really didn't think there was a chance for Contreras to get to that one. And at the last second, he leaps and almost like a falling over dive, if you will, landing on your back type thing. But he was able to get a glove on it, snow cones that thing. I don't know what flavor it was. I don't think he took a lick, but he was able to bring that down, hold on to it, and make the play out there at second. Just tremendous play. Yoshida now with the 1-2 on the way, fouls it off down the right side. And Yoshida will watch that one come through and even out the count at 2-2. So, full count here. And Arteaga looking to end this inning with a K, does not, just misses on the fastball that time. And he'll issue the walk to Yoshida. So we'll have Aubrey Reed here coming to the plate. He's 0-1, and this one struck out his first time facing Arteaga. Getting a little wetter as the evening or afternoon goes on. I say evening, it's just a little darker because of the cloud cover, that's all. It's 4:03 local time here, mountain time in Hobbs, New Mexico. This one fouled off by Reed, out of play on the right side, so an 0-1 count here with a runner at first and two outs for the Bulldogs. Aubrey Reed will dig back in here. He's playing over at first base in this contest. And that one outside as it tails that way off the hands of Arteaga, and it'll be a 1-1 count. Do nothing your score here. Top half of the fourth inning with a runner on and two outs for Clarendon College as Arteaga bounces that one in, and it'll be a 2-1 count. So now a slight lead for Yoshida at first. Arteaga a peek over there. Yoshida takes another step. And now comes to the plate. It'll get past the catcher, Maud. And it'll allow a base here for Yoshida as he'll take second. Now a 3-1 count here to Aubrey Reed as Arteaga will take a second to collect himself before he steps back up on the rubber. And that will get by Maud again. Yoshida heading towards third. And a walk issued there by Arteaga will put runners on the corners here. So that will bring up Daniel Oviedo here, playing at third in this contest, wearing number 11. Right-handed hitter. First time up, had a single. Looks like he's got another one at least, as that one will hit the gap out in right center and roll to the wall. One run is in for Clarendon College, and now a second one coming here as the throw, good throw, just a bit late. Maud is able to put a mitt on it and hold Oviedo at second. He's 1-for-2 with a double and a single. Two RBI now, and we're tied at two here in the fourth inning. Oviedo providing a spark for this Bulldog squad in the fourth inning here. Top half of the fourth, tied up at two now after the double. Hard hit ball. And that brings up a lefty here. And that is Matos, the catcher. Now a timeout called here, and Mike Robbins out. Usually it's Mike. I believe it's Mike. It is. See the rag in the back pocket there. 1-0 count. Arteaga struggled, has walked a couple here, and then gave up that hard hit ball. And he's out to settle his pitcher down is Mike Robbins. 2-2 as we are two-thirds of the way through the top half of this fourth inning. Clarendon scoring twice a moment ago on that double by Oviedo. As Matos again will step into the batter's box, left-handed hitter. So Angel Matos looking at the 1-0 here coming from Isaiah Arteaga. He'll miss again. This one low, a 2-0 count here. Again, T-Birds do have an arm ready in the bullpen, it would appear. Another righty, can't see his number from here. And the 2-0 now. Low again for a 3-0 count. As Matos probably taking the whole way here. Two outs in the inning and a runner at second for Clarendon. A base hit could give Clarendon the lead for the first time this weekend. Arteaga deals, misses inside with the fastball. And now runners at first and second here for Clarendon. That'll do it for Arteaga as Mike back out of the dugout. And we'll have information on your new pitcher when we come back. Nature calls for me, and we're going to take this break. All right, back here at the ballpark after the pitching change for the Thunderbirds. And missing a couple of pitches, of course, with the commentary. It's Menchaca to lift this one out to left. And the play made out there to end the inning. But a 2-2 game after two cross the plate for the Bulldogs here in the top half of the fourth. We'll have the T-Birds up to bat when we come back. All right, we're back again here at Ray Birmingham Thunderbird Field, bottom half of the fourth, and an increasingly wet turf and bleacher area as that mist just keeps on coming in. We'll call it a drizzle now. I'm not a meteorologist, though, so, you know, don't take my word for it. It'll be Lachlan Maud coming to the plate here. For the T-Birds to stop or start this bottom half of inning number four. Clarendon tying the game up in the top half of the inning as Maud will step up. Strike comes across here from Bell. As Maud sees that one bend back across. That one looked like the same spot, called a ball this time, but a 1-1 count. Jaron Foster on deck here for your Thunderbirds. That's going to be a ball called there from the home plate umpire for Miller Bell to make it a 2-1 count. Now this one chopped over towards third. It's played by Daniel Oviedo. He'll get it across in time to retire Maud on the grounder, 5-3. So that will bring Foster up here. Foster reached base his first time up and turned the wheels on there for a moment as well. And we will have Contreras behind him. First pitch is a strike on the fastball across the plate to Foster. That one just misses. You could hear the groans on one side and the cheers on the other by the dugouts here as that fastball is called outside. There's a swing and a miss there by Foster, and it'll make it a 1-2 count. Come on, let's go. Now 2-2 is out on a bounce here on the offering from Bell. Toss the ball out there, get a new one as it's a little wet out here. Now a strikeout as Foster will go down. Bell kind of finding a rhythm here through the past couple of innings.
Up to bat number two, Pepe Contreras.
And that'll bring up the second baseman, Pepe Contreras. Contreras with a fantastic defensive play in the top half of this inning to make that second out. Looked like T-Birds were well on their way out to come back into the dugout up 2-0, but Clarendon had a little something to say about it, tied it up at two apiece, and Contreras will take a ball up high with two outs here in the bottom half of the fourth. Contreras now will swing and foul that one off. 1-1 to count. Contreras' first time up, grounded out. And now we'll get hit by a pitch in the backside. And now hops a little bit there as he's rubbing the area. And T-Birds have a base runner on here with two outs in the fourth. Tied at two in this one. T-Birds have taken the first three games of the set from Clarendon College. As Luis Urias will come to the plate, we may have another new pitcher, this time for the Bulldogs here. But doesn't look like he's quite ready to go. Still standing and just tossing out in that right field bullpen are the Bulldogs. So coach out to speak with Miller Bell, the pitcher from Australia here, out on the mound before Luis Urias comes to the plate. Urias in this one, 0-2 with a strikeout and a flyout. As the shortstop steps in here. Decent lead over at first for Urias. Though Bell comes to the plate, throws behind. Contreras at first. Urias is who they threw behind. Man, I'm getting lost here. Brain freeze in a whole different way. We're tied at two, bottom half of the fourth inning. T-Birds with a runner in scoring position now. After that ball went behind Urias on the pitch from Miller Bell. Way outside on his second offering, and it's a 2-0 count. Go ahead, run at second base here for the T-Birds, but there are two out in this bottom half of the fourth. Iredale is on deck for New Mexico, should Urias reach. Swing and a miss on the big cut that time from Luis, and it's a 2-1 count. So Bell will take his time here. Contreras with a big lead off at second base. And Bell comes to the plate. He'll miss low. It'll be a 3-1 count. Going to be a pretty steady supply of dry baseballs coming in here. It's still just a bit wet here at the ballpark. Out. Oh, a strike called. Urias is going to have to come back. That caught the outside part of the plate, and it'll be a 3-2 count here. Yeah, it'll be 3-2. There's Holly Reyna operating the scoreboard, doing a great job this weekend. All the folks here at New Mexico Junior College always do, and thankful to everybody who pitches in for these broadcasts. Odias hits this one sky high and shallow center. Contreras was on his horse already running. This time Brownlee is able to squeeze it, and the T-Birds will leave one stranded here. So we're through four, 2-2 your score in this last game of the weekend here at Ray Birmingham Thunderbird Field. Bulldogs will be up to bat when we come back. Back here at Ray Birmingham Thunderbird Field. And some great baseball being played over the weekend. T-Birds have really come alive offensively, although we're into the fifth inning here. And it's a 2-2 game here in the final. The T-Birds winning 21-2, 19-0, and 10-4 in the first three of this set. And really have hit the ball well. By the way, the pitcher on in relief for the Thunderbirds was Alejandro Maltos Garcia. He recorded the final out of the fourth inning and now in to pitch the fifth here. First up will be the center fielder, Brownlee. And we'll see what he can do here. Alejandro Maltos Garcia gets a pop-up in foul territory that will eventually get out of play down the right side for an 0-1 count. A little quiet at the ballpark here as the game continues to go on. Now this ball chopped foul the other way. 0-2 now to Brownlee. Top half of the fifth. And an 0-2 count to the leadoff batter of the inning, Brownlee. Also the leadoff batter in the game, I guess you will. He hits in the one hole. So, roller, and got him at first off the stretch from Vlasic as Urias is able to get the strong throw across, and Vlasic able to keep a toe on the bag, and in a bang-bang play, the out called. So, is that Malish is up? Yes, it is, Aiden Malish. First pitch is across for a strike from Maltos Garcia. So Garcia now ready to go again. Looks like heading out to the bullpen will be another T-Bird arm in the form of Villarreal. Jason Villarreal, number 18, perhaps. Slow roller towards second. Safe on the dive at first, but you don't want to do that, man. He landed right on the bag. And I know Malish is feeling that one. He landed right with the ribs on the bag. He did beat the throw, however, and now there's a base runner there for the Bulldogs. He'll try to walk this one off, man. Sometimes there's a reason they tell you not to dive into first base on one of those. Malish will stay in the game, and Maltos Garcia here will face Fernandez. So that slow roller ends up being an infield single as hustling it out is Malish. And the Bulldogs have a runner on with one away here in the fifth. That one gets away from Maltos Garcia and goes up above the head of Fernandez. 1-0 count. The 1-0 across for a strike from Alejandro Maltos Garcia. 1-1 the count now to Fernandez. That one a strike as well. Good pitch that time from Alejandro. 1-2 the count here. And a miss low and away that time from Garcia. 2-2 the count. Again, we're in the top half of the fifth inning. This is a nine-inning affair. And way up high with that one was Garcia. So a full count here now to Christian Fernandez. Both teams with action in the bullpen now as they're settling in for the long haul. Swing and a miss. That's a strikeout there. The throw from Maude Lachlan. Maude gets the runner at second. And that's a strike him out, throw him out, double play. T-Birds out of the fifth. They'll be ready to hit when we come back. Tied at two. Jesus Rujano back out on the bump here for Clarendon College as we head into the bottom half of the fifth inning in at a soggy Ray Birmingham Thunderbird Field. Iredale will be the first batter of the inning for the T-Birds. Brent Iredale followed by, I believe it's going to be Vlasic now as he'll be hitting in place of Lane Arroyos. Rujano misses with his first. It's a 1-0 count. Halfway through the ball game here as we're through 4.5. This one will miss as well from Rujano. Low and out. So ball two. 2-0 the count. T-Birds scored two in the second. They were answered with two in the fourth by Clarendon, and that's where we stand. Fouling that one off is Iredell. And That bender just didn't quite bend far enough back in that time. 3-1 your count, as that one was well outside from Rujano to Iredell. So Brent steps in way outside on the fastball for Jesus Rujano. And Iredell will draw a leadoff walk.
At the plate, number 7, Travis Vlasic.
So Vlasic coming to the dish here. Had a good game one. And runner goes. No chance for Matos to throw him out there as that ball came way inside on Vlasic. It'll be a 1-0 count. And taking second was Brent Iredell on the steal. Got a good lead again. Rujano now looking towards the mound. See if he'll check the runner at second. He'll look over. Dancing is Iredell. This one way inside again. 2-0 now to Travis Vlasic. Again, Iredell over at second in scoring position with nobody out here for the T-Birds in the bottom half of this fifth inning. Way inside again. 3-0 quickly to Vlasic. See if they give a green light to Travis here or if they just have him take the whole way. Rujano struggling with the zone right now. Jonathan Clough on deck for the Thunderbirds. And that is a four-pitch walk. May see the change coming here. There's still arms in the bullpen. No, it's just going to be the catcher out to talk with the pitcher this time. So Clough coming to the plate after the walk to Travis Vlasic. Two on here as Iredell's at second, Vlasic at first, and Clough at the plate. 0-for-1 in this one. He's walked once and struck out once. And there's the pitch. It'll bounce. Iredell will take third as he had a decent head start with a huge lead over there as Matos blocks it but can't keep it in front of him. 1-0 now here to Clough. Got a timeout called here. And wiping down the ball is Rujano out there. 1-0 count here to Clough. With runners on the corners, nobody out here in a tie game in the fifth. There's a throw over to first and it's thrown away. Clear to the wall, that'll score Iredell. All the way to third possibly is going to be Vlasic. He is able to reach third. The ball cut off by the pitcher, Rujano, after he had thrown it to the wall over the head of the first baseman. And the T-Birds regain the lead at 3-2. Now we're going to have the timeout, and we are going to have a pitching change here. So Clarendon goes to the pen with a 1-0 count here against Jonathan Clough in the fifth. T-Birds have Vlasic at third and nobody out, and a 3-2 lead. We'll be back. New pitcher for Clarendon will be Chase Chabi again, and for the second time today. He was in game one, now back here in game two, as he will toe the rubber. Chabi will look to deal to Clough with a 1-0 count as he inherited that. First pitch misses for a ball. It's going to be inside for ball two. 2-0. And T-Birds still have a runner at third. We're in the bottom half of this fifth inning. They pushed one across to take that 3-2 lead on a bad pickoff move or throw, actually, from Rujano, the previous pitcher, as it hits all the way to the wall by the dugout. Vlasic went from first to third. And it was Iredale who scored the run there. Swing and a miss there on Clough again. And a couple of breaking balls way out in front of him is Jonathan. And it's 2-2. So the 2-2 on its way. Strikes him out on the outside part of the plate with the fastball. Just fooled him. Clough will head back to the dugout with his second strikeout in the game. As he was caught looking that time. That's going to bring up Eric Bayania, who has not had a great day offensively, but is due here. Bayania's walked and struck out in this one. Struck out three times and had a pop-up in game one today. And is ahead in count 1-0. Still a runner at third here for the T-Birds and one out in the fifth. And that ball is hit out towards right, tailing like it's going to get out of play in foul territory. It is caught out there on the fly, but that'll score the run. So a sac fly RBI there for Bayania. As Vlasic comes across and makes it a 4-2 game. So 4-2, as it will be Christian Hoffman, the young man from Rio Rancho, New Mexico, up at the plate, batting from the left side, takes a ball here. And it's a 1-0 count. 4-2 lead now for the T-Birds, as they have gotten two to cross the plate here in the bottom half of the fifth. Two outs now and nobody on for Hoffman. That one will miss as well. Looks like it might have been a bit outside that time, perhaps even high. We'll not speculate on the umpire's decision to call that a ball. It's just 2-0. Up high, definitely that time for a 3-0 count here. And stepping back in is Hoffman. Green light or red light here, we'll see. Red light, as that ball was up high anyhow. A walk issued on four pitches to Hoffman. And that'll bring up Maud. Lachlan Maud coming to the plate here. Got him at 0 for 1, 0 for 2 in the game. Nope. Don't have him. I've screwed up my scorebook here. Too wet. The app got to where it was a little too cold. The hands are freezing over here. 0-1 after that one bends across for a strike here to Maud. Maud will poke it out into right field. Looks like he'll get down for a hit. It will be a base hit. The single there as the throw comes into second and advances Hoffman to third. So runners at the corners with two outs here for Jaron Foster. Good day for Lachlan Maud getting another hit here. Oh, man. I don't know if there's a run rule after five innings, but I tell you what, if they drop about 20 up here, it'd be great. Again, runners at first and third here for Jayron Foster. Finding the outside edge of the plate that time is Chase Chabby. 0-1 count to Foster. Foster 0-for-1, struck out swinging and walked in the game. And 1-1 is that one will miss here. Chabby gets that one across on the off-speed pitch, and it's 1-2 now to Foster. So two away, a ball and two strikes with runners at the corners for the T-Birds. There's the throw to first, trying to get Maude leaning. They do not. He's back in safely on the dive. Now going is Maude, and he'll easily swipe second on the low fastball that time, called a ball behind the plate. 2-2 now here to Jayron Foster. So runners at second and third now with two outs. 2-2 count here to Foster in the bottom half of the fifth. And he'll swing through it. Strikeout on the swing. There, Chabby records the K. And that'll do it for the T-Birds in the fifth. We head to the sixth. 4-2, NMJC over Clarendon. We'll be back. All right, back here for inning number six as the T-Birds take a 4-2 lead in the bottom half of the fifth on a couple of miscues by the Bulldogs. They've had a few on the weekend. T-Birds have taken advantage of most of those, and it will be Maltos Garcia back out on the mound, I believe, for this sixth inning. It is. He'll miss inside. Is that correct? Oh, they called a ball there. They did. That one is a strike called this time. Big Ruddy gets it across. And it's a 1-1 count here. This one's going to be weakly fouled back and go off the center block back here by Courtney. Stephen Courtney here. So we got a 1-2. And now 2-2 as that one will bounce out. Maude able to block it there. And they'll toss that ball out of play as it got wet. And let me double check this. So Montrose Garcia is still on the bump here. There is an arm out in the bullpen warming up for the Thunderbirds. Also one out for the Bulldogs. So ready to go again after the ball walked out to the pitcher here by the home plate umpire. 2-2 is your count here to Stephen Courtney. Garcia deals. Looked like it was right down the middle. About belt high, might have been a bit in. That's the only thing I can think of for that pitch to not be called a strike, and it's a full count. 3-2. Garcia has this one swung on and driven on a line right in between third and short for a base hit into left field. And Courtney starts it off with a single here in the sixth for Clarendon. So that'll bring up Yoshida, the second baseman here. Yoshida 0 for 1 in this one. A strikeout and a walk. He'll try to lay down the bunt. He'll go foul back behind the plate. Model toss that one out of play and toss a new ball to the pitcher, Maltos Garcia. Lefty in the bullpen for the T-Birds out getting ready. Be a righty for the Bulldogs on the other side. Showing bunt, pulling it back just in time on an outside pitch from the breaking ball from Garcia. Evens out the count at a ball and a strike here. 4-2, top half, sixth inning. T-Birds up by two here at home. Yoshida will lay down the bunt this time. It is going to be picked up by Garcia. He'll get the out at first as the runner is moved over in the form of Courtney.
Up to bat, number 7, Reed.
So the bunt will move Courtney over to second. And it will bring up Aubrey Reed. That ball getting away from Garcia that time just slipped out of his hands way up high and well over the head of everybody. Another ball tossed out of play here. And it's 1-0 count as the runner is able to get to third here. Garcia now deals right down the pike. No, they'll call a ball. From where I said, no. But either way, 2-0 to count now. With a runner at third after the wild pitch. And just one out here in the sixth. It looked like he offered there. They're going to have the strike call. And it's 2-1. Swing and a miss by Reed. That time we'll even it out at 2 balls and 2 strikes here. Garcia will look to get this one across to Aubrey Reed. Bounces there in front of plate. Mod with a great block behind the dish that time to keep it in front of him and keep the runner at third. That could have scored and made this a one-run game. Full count now here to Aubrey Reed. And this ball is going to be hit off the barrel into right field. It will score a run. An RBI single here for Aubrey Reed, and it's back to a one-run game. That'll bring up Oviedo. Oviedo now with a chance here. He's 2 for 2, a single and a double his last time up, and takes a strike here from Garcia. 0-1 to count, just one away, runner at first here for Clarendon, who has just scored to make it a one-run game here in the sixth. 4-3. Up high is Garcia with that offering. It's 1-1. The TaylorMade double play ball here would be great for the Thunderbirds. Not so great for the Bulldogs, and a swing and a miss by Oviedo on that one makes it a 1-2 count. Continues to just get more and more wet here in the stands. And a swing and a miss by Oviedo will... Oh, they're going to say, what? That should be it, right? Okay, he turned around. He was going to... Still bad, and I thought, wait, I know I didn't miss something there. We've got a timeout called, and that'll do it for Alejandro Maltos Garcia. Robbins will go to the bullpen here and bring in the lefty. We'll have more info on that when we come back. 4-3 game, still here in the top of the sixth inning. T-Birds ahead. New pitcher will be Monty Bogner for the T-Birds. The lefty will come in. One of my favorite names on the team, just because he shares that with my dearly departed old father, my dad Monty as well. And love to see that name out there. So, Mr. Bogner, your parents named you a perfect name. I'll tell you that right now. So Bogner will come in here throwing from the left side with two outs in the sixth, top half of it. One run across for Clarendon in the inning to make it a one-run game. T-Bird's still up 4-3 here. First pitch from Bogner's across for a strike. Bogner deals again. Holding off somehow on that one, and he knows it was Matos there at the plate. Angel Matos, the catcher, walked his time up. Inside and quick, and Matos will take that for a ball. Of course, the jaw was agape after that. as that ball had some heat coming inside from the lefty. Bogner gets this one across. It's a ground ball to Urias. He'll wait on it, get it to Contreras, and that will end the inning on the fielder's choice. So the T-Birds now up 4-3 through 5.5. We'll complete the sixth inning when we get back. All right, back here again for the bottom half of the sixth. I'm Dusty Windham. The T-Birds clinging to a one-run lead as they come to bat here in the home half here. 4-3 the score after just decimating Clarendon yesterday, 21-2, 19-0 as well. And then started off today pretty well. 10-4 victory in game one. Here we are. And the tail end of the weekend series, and the colder the weather's got, the colder the bats have gotten, it seems. 4-3, though, T-Birds still in the lead here. Chase Chabi back out on the bump to start this sixth inning for the Bulldogs, who are in green. T-Birds are in black here at home today.
Up to bat for the Thunderbirds, number 2, Pepe Contreras.
So, to lead it off, it will be the second baseman, Pepe Contreras. Coming up, he's been hit by a pitch and grounded out in this one, 0-1 on the afternoon. Just past the 5 o'clock hour here now in Hobbs, New Mexico. When they say it's 5 o'clock somewhere, it's here. It's here now. Up high with the first offering is Jobby, and it's 1-0. T-Birds have been able to hit the ball pretty well all weekend. Of course, cold, drizzly, windy here in game number 4, and a strike on the off-speed pitch from Chabi. 1-1 to count here to Contreras. Outside on that one from Chabi, and 2-1 is your count. Contreras back in. The pitch coming up high and inside to Pepe that time. 3-1 to count. And the 3-1 up high. It's going to be a walk issued here. And the T-Birds have the leadoff man on here in the bottom half of the sixth. Contreras will take his place at first base, and it will be Luis Urias at the plate here. The shortstop 0-3 in this one. Struck out and 2 pop-ups in game number 4. But has had a good weekend at the plate other than this fourth game. Chabi goes up high with a bender and trying to bunt it was Urias. It'll go off the bottom of the bat and back to the center block here, and it's 0-1. Back to first goes Contreras. T-Birds looking for some insurance here. Just up a run in the sixth. And with nobody out and a runner on, they'll look to score more. The pickoff throw up a bit high, but this time able to come down with it was Reed. And that'll keep Contreras over at first. 0-1 count here to Urias as Luis steps back in. Chavi comes to the plate. This one is hit the other way into right field. Contreras will turn and try to make it to third. He will as the throw's cut off there by Menchaca at short. And now runners on the corners with nobody out for the T-Birds after the single to right from Urias. That'll bring up Brent Iredell. Iredell, a leader on this team. He's a veteran, if you will, on a two-year team, of course. But, you know, he is a leader for these T-Birds, and he's been able to lead with his bat and with his glove at times. And taking second easily is going to be Urias on the steal attempt, as that one's across for a strike to Iredell on the first pitch from Chavi. Now, the off-speed fouled off by Iredell there, as I think he was fooled. He was out in front of him, kind of just had to let the ball go off the barrel and, you know, foul it off there to stay with it. 0-2 the count. Nobody out. Runners at second and third here for the T-Birds, and Iredell will foul that one off. That one hit solid on one of the beams here. Overhang. Barehanded play made on the ricochet by Travis Vlasic in the on-deck circle. So back into the box is Brent Iredell, down 0-2. As Chavi looks towards second, comes to the plate. Iredell gets a single out into left field. One run is in. Urias here will score, and they've got Iredell in a rundown, but the run did come across as he drew some attention from the infielder, and in the pickle he's finally tagged out is Iredell. And there's one away, but two runs across the plate to double up the Bulldogs now. 6-3, the T-Birds are ahead. So Iredell got the single into left, scoring two runs. And ballooning the lead from 1-3 here for New Mexico Junior College. Vlasic now steps up and pops one up to shallow right center. The right fielder under it. He will squeeze it, and there's two away.
That's about number 20, Jonathan
Clough. So Vlasic after the flyout will give way to Jonathan Clough as he'll step in. Chavi will miss outside with the first offering. It's a 1-0 count. And with the 1-0, he'll miss outside again. 2-0 your count here to Clough. Clough will foul that one off down the right side, making it a 2-1 count. Two down here now in the bottom half of the sixth. T-Birds have scored twice in each the second, fifth, and sixth innings of this one, have a 6-3 lead and lead the weekend series 3-0, 5-2 in conference play after the weekend. And Clough right up the middle with a knock. Hard hit ball into center, a single here for Jonathan Clough.
That's about number 4, Eric Bayania.
So Bayania will now come to the plate, Eric. Tough day offensively, as we've said, but he's been solid out in the field. Not only that, he has got the wheels. When he is on base, he can move, flat out move, and does so many things. Another leader on this team. This ball's hit right back up the box, too. Clough's going to take third as he was running on the pitch. Bayania with his first hit all day. single up the middle for Eric, and good to see him get off the schneid there. It's going to be Hoffman coming to the plate now, the big lefty from Rio Rancho, with runners on the corners and two outs here in the bottom half of inning number six. Bionia will swipe second as they're just letting them run from first now, are the Bulldogs in this matchup. T-Birds have swiped a number of bases on the weekend. Now he's swinging a miss by Hoffman there on the breaking ball, and it's a 1-1 count. And that one's in for a strike on the pitch from Chobby, who seems frustrated out there on the mound here. Runners at second and third, two outs for the T-Birds. They lead at 6-3, bottom half of the sixth inning, and a 1-2 count here to Christian Hoffman. Way up and outside that time as he lost that one, did Chobby, and it's 2-2. Two hours and 7 minutes into game number two of the day. And in the bottom half of the sixth, T-Birds threatening still with two outs, though. 3-2 now as they'll miss with that pitch to Hoffman Will Chobby, and Michael Mott may get another chance to bat here in the inning. He's on deck should Hoffman reach with two on and two out. Runners are at second and third. Chobby to the plate. Hoffman foul down the right side, and he'll get another look. Tell you what, he hit a ball to center field in the first game that yesterday would have left the park by about 30 or 40 feet. The wind blowing in today, plus the heavier air here. But that ball went off the top of the wall for a triple. Chobby to the plate. Hoffman fouls this one. Well, pops it up anyways. It looked like it might get foul on that left side. It's going to stay fair, and the play is going to be made out left by the Bulldogs. So after six, T-Birds lead it 6-3, and they'll take the field here for the seventh as Clarendon will try to cut into the lead yet again. We'll be back with more T-Bird baseball. Monty Bugner back out on the mound to start this now into the seventh inning. We are here at Ray Birmingham Thunderbird Field. It's a 6-3 lead for your Thunderbirds as the Bulldogs come to bat here in the seventh. Nine outs to work with, down three runs here. And we're ready to roll. It will be Menchaca, the shortstop, up first for this Bulldog squad, who here in about an hour or so are going to be taking on in men's basketball your Thunderbirds at the Region 5 tournament. Come on, T-Birds. Really good squad. Head coach Luke McKay has there. Jordan Burton, the assistant coach. And this ball smoked right up the middle off the first pitch by Bogner, by Menchaca. He'll have a single, his first hit in game number two here today.
Up to bat, number 14, Brownlee.
And that'll bring up the leadoff man, Brownlee, the center fielder. Brownlee today, or at least in this ball game, is 0 for 3. He has two grounded outs and a fielder's choice he hit into. Still drizzling a bit here at the ballpark. Tell you what, my feet are soaked. That ball now up high from Bogner. It's a 1-0 count. As Brownlee steps back in, shows bunt. Ball up and in a bit. They think on the other dugout, they think that was a little further inside than it was. From here behind the plate, wasn't that far inside, and Brownlee easily had room. That fastball catches the inside part of the plate for a strike, and it's 2-1 now to Brownlee. Runner at first, nobody out here in the 7th for Clarendon as they trail your Thunderbirds 6-3. There's the bunt laid down, but it'll go foul down the right side. Now 2-2 is the count. T-Birds with a righty up in the bullpen here, just getting loose, and a righty out there for the Bulldogs as well. Back in the box is Brownlee. Bogner steps up on the rubber. And he'll go behind Brownlee. It'll get all the way to the backstop. Taking second is going to be Menchaca on the wild pitch. So a full count now. Bogner will head back to the mound, regroup, and try to get this one passed Brownlee. This one popped back, foul into the screen, and looks like it got up over the overhang here. And we'll do another payoff pitch. Runner at second here for Clarendon. We're in the top half of the 7th. Nobody out in a 6-3 game that your Thunderbirds lead. Swing and a miss, and there's the strikeout for Bogner. And there's one away. That'll bring up Malish, I believe. Double check as we get him in there. It looks like it. Hitting from the right side this time. And gets one through the infield into left. The throw coming in here. And meet at the plate. Oh, what a bad call. That's a Maude catches that one. What a throw from left field from Bionia. That guy was meet at the plate. There's no way he was safe. Oh, man. If he was safe, then Vlasic was safe on his side earlier easily. That's a horrible call by the man behind the plate, and now that's going to do it for Bogner, I almost bet you. That was, oh. Either way, 6-4 is your score now, and we will have a pitching change. We'll be back with more T-Bird Baseball in a minute. New pitcher for the T-Birds will be Santana Hernandez in a 6-4 ball game here in the seventh inning, the top half of the seventh. A run just scoring, and now I know why they call umpires blue. I'll leave it there. No, I won't. He blew that call. That was a great throw in from Bionia out in left field. Maud catches it. Definitely had the tag down in front of that, and just a missed call. It happens. 6-4. As Fernandez will step into the plate, he'll take on Hernandez. So Hernandez to Fernandez here. Both righties. Runner at first and just one out, inexplicably. But just one out. As that one is a ball called there. Now a fastball in the dirt from Hernandez, and it's 2-0. Swing and a drive out into left center. It's into the gap. Bionia is up with it. He'll throw to third. And talk about meat. The guy would have been dead by about a mile had Malish tried to take third. Of course, don't know what the call would have been, but he would have been, at least the throw would have beat him there by about 30 feet, 40 feet even. So the single puts runners at first and second here with one away. And there's a double play ball, perhaps Contreras to Urias, back to Vlasic at first. And that'll do it there for the top half of this seventh inning as the Bulldogs fail to capitalize there. Great job by the middle infield there for the T-Birds to lock it down and secure the inning by just the one run coming across. 6-4 your score. T-Birds will be back up to bat in the bottom half of the seventh when we come back. New pitcher in for this Clarendon College team will be number 17, Mr. Black.
Up to bat for your Thunderbirds, number 21.
If I can get back to his roster, get his first name here. Pardon me, folks. Lachlan Maud will lead off the inning for the T-Birds here in the bottom half of the seventh against Mr. Black here. Drew Black is the name, Fort Worth, Texas. What he's listed at on the website here. So T-Birds up 6-4, looking to add to it as Maude will lead it off here. Righty-righty matchup. Way outside on the first offering for a ball. It's 1-0. Black looks in. Comes to the plate. Maude will foul it off down the right side. It'll get out of play and it'll be a 1-1 count. Temperature dropping a little bit here now again as we're near, well, it's 5:25 in Mountain Time here. And that ball go way outside as Montos is able to keep it in front of him. It's 2-1. And Black ready to come to the dish. He will. Maude fouls that one hard. And I mean hard as it just barely misses. Laro Felix coaching first base over there. Laro wasn't scared. You see him flinch? No way. That man's faced bigger fears than that, I'm sure. I don't know. That's a pretty hard hit ball by Maude. 2-2 now here, and outside with that one is Black. He'll miss, and it's a full count. Lachlan will hit this one over towards second. Slow roller up with it is Yoshida, and he just blows the throw that time. Another error here by the Bulldogs, and safe at first is going to be Lachlan Maude on the error. So Jorge De Los Santos will check in here. He'll hit for Foster, I believe, in that spot. And first pitch, he'll swing, drive it to the right side. It will go foul and into the parking lot here. So 0-1 here to De Los Santos with a runner at first in Lachlan Maude. Black to the plate. It's going to be low that time. And a ball. 1-1 to count. Now a toss over to first. Maude will dive head first back into the bag and be there safely. And the 1-1 on its way. Fouled hard down the left side this time by De Los Santos. Maude will retreat back to first after the foul ball. And the count will sit at 1-2. Nobody out. Bottom half of the seventh inning. T-Birds with a two-run lead at 6-4. De Los Santos pokes one into left. It'll bounce twice before Malish is able to come up with it. And T-Birds have something cooking. Two on, nobody out here after back-to-back singles. And coming to the plate is going to be Pepe Contreras here for the Thunderbirds. Mike Robbins wanted a word with him before he stepped in the batter's box. He'll get that chance. And for Contreras, he's grounded out. He's walked and been hit by a pitch in 0-for-1 day officially. Showing bunt. Black comes to the dish. Getting it down is Contreras. Good bunt. It's only play is going to be at first for Black. They are able to punch out Contreras, but that'll put two on in scoring position now for Luis Urias as Maude and also De Los Santos are on the bags. Bottom But what a bunt laid down there by Contreras. And now, first pitch swinging is Urias. He gets it. All right, I tell you what, that was a heck of a shot. I thought it was going to get over the head out and left of the fielder. But scoring on the tag up is going to be Lachlan Maud. T-Birds now up three again. It is 7-4 here after the sac fly. So after the fly ball from Urias, there's two away here with a runner at second for the T-Birds. They lead it 7-4 in the bottom half of seventh. Brent Iredale coming to the plate here. Right across the heart of the plate for a strike from Drew Black that time to Iredale. 0-1 to count. The 0-1 swung on right over at third. Oviedo up with it, and he'll get it across in time to retire Iredale, and that'll do it for the T-Birds in the seventh. So now through seven, it is 7-4. Your Thunderbirds with the lead, looking for the series sweep. Top of the eighth when we come back. Santana Hernandez back out on the bump for the T-Birds to begin this eighth inning. T-Birds leading it 7-4 as Clarendon comes to the plate. Clarendon scoring two back in the fourth inning and one each in the sixth and seventh. T-Birds enjoying a three-run lead right this moment, but need to keep that momentum going. So Hernandez will be on the bump trying to make that happen. Should be Rui Yoshida coming to the plate here. He's 0-1 with a strikeout, a sack bunt, and a walk in the game. Behind Yoshida, we'll see if they make any changes. It's Aubrey Reed is who it will be. So he's still in the lineup here for the Bulldogs as well as we begin the eighth. We're 2 hours, 31 minutes into game number four of this series. T-Birds have won each of the first three, 21-2, and 19-0 yesterday winners over Clarendon. Hernandez has missed with his first two offerings to Yoshida here, and it's a 2-0 count. Still another arm loosening up in the bullpen, just tossing at this moment for the Thunderbirds. So we'll see if Hernandez can finish this one out. Ground ball over to Iredale at third. He's up with it. Quickly throwing over to Vlasic, and the out is made. Yoshida retired on that one.
That's about number seven, Reed.
And now we'll bring up Aubrey Reed with one away here in the eighth. Reed 1-for-2. He's walked, struck out swinging, and singled in the game. Oof, looked like a strike from here, no call, or didn't get the call, I guess I should say. 1-0 to count here. Now this ball hit sharply at second. Contreras boots it for a moment, recovers, and gets it to Vlasic just in time to retire Reed. So way to keep it in front of you. That's why they tell you that, youngsters. Keep the ball in front of you. Give yourself a chance to make play. Contreras did off the one hopper there. And that brings up Oviedo. So two away here in the eighth now, and Hernandez will miss with that pitch outside. A 1-0 count now to Oviedo. Oviedo, 2-for-3, struck out, singled, and doubled in the game. That one's in for a strike there, and it's a 1-1 count. Hernandez efficient this inning, no doubt. He's only thrown four pitches. Oh, that one will bounce there. And he did go around, they'll rule, so that is a strike, a 1-2 count now here to Oviedo. You could call it a long four-game set. You'd probably be right if all the weather was like this today, but yesterday, just a beautiful day for baseball here at Ray Birmingham Thunderbird Field as Hernandez misses just barely outside on that pitch to Oviedo. 2-2 count here, 7-4 game. Ooh, up and in that time. Oviedo able to back out of the way of that one, and the count now full. So much for the efficiency I was talking about, right? Hernandez quickly into it. Gets a pop-up to right. Long way to go out there for Hoffman. It's going to be a fair ball just inside the line, and a double here for Oviedo. His second of the contest, 3-for-4 day for him. Bright spot here for these Bulldogs on the weekend who have been outscored now 57 to 10 on the weekend.
Number five, Matos.
So Matos, the catcher, will come back up hitting from the left side with two outs and a runner at second here. Hernandez delivers. It's going to be a called ball there, low, 1-0 to count. The 1-0 now on its way from Santana Hernandez. Good bounce, get away from Maud. He recovers, not quite in time to get the throw across, so taking third on that one is going to be Oviedo. 0-for-1 day for Matos. He's walked and grounded out. Third AB here. 2-0 now from Hernandez to Matos. Seven four game again. Two outs here in the eighth. Looked like he went there. They're gonna say he did, and that's gonna be a strike. 2-1 now the count here. As Hernandez will look to deal again. He's working pretty darned quickly here. This ball hit right over at third. Iredale's up with it. The long throw to first. Got him, and that'll do it for the Bulldogs in the eighth. So they've got three outs to work with when the T-Birds relinquish the batter's box back to them. We'll head to the bottom half of the eighth inning with the T-Birds up 7-4 here at home in Game 4 of the weekend set. T-Birds took the first three. We'll be back. quick little snapshot to tell you about how the weekend has gone for each team as we begin this eighth inning, or in this eighth inning, as the T-Birds are coming up to bat in the bottom half. You look in the dugouts. Everybody sitting down for Clarendon, as it's been a long weekend for them, as T-Bird bats came alive. Yesterday just ripped it up, scoring 40 runs in those two matches. Today, 10-4 winners in game one, now up 7-4 here as we begin the bottom of the eighth. T-Bird dugout, everybody standing, everybody chattering. And just a little picture of what's gone on through the weekend. Travis Vlasic will be up first here. And he will face Black again. Drew Black out on the mound. And this ball slapped towards second. Yoshida up with it. Will retire Vlasic at first here. That'll bring up Jonathan Clough here. The center fielder will come up.
Up to bat, number 20, Jonathan Clough.
So Clough will head to the batter's box here with one away in the eighth. And the bases are empty. He'll go the other way to get this one through the infield, and a base knock into right. The throw comes into Yoshida, and on base with a single there is Clough. That'll bring up Bionia. Got his first hit of the day, his last time up, with a single. And we'll see what happens here with Bionia, as going was Clough on the first pitch, a hit and run on there, and Bionia fouled off to the right side. One for two officially in this ball game is Bionia. He's walked, struck out, had a sac fly and a single. Looking at the runner is Black. Now he'll come to the plate. Clough goes anyways. The throw from Matos way behind, and he'll get into center field. Clough will take third here, as coming up with it is Brownlee out in center. So the T-Birds now with a runner at third and an out, and a 1-1 count here to Eric Bionia. So Black now towing the rubber, gets back up there, gets a look in at the catcher, decides what he wants to do, and he'll come to the plate way inside, almost got by a knee again. 2-1. On deck is Hoffman for your Thunderbirds, Christian Hoffman. Up high with that one is Black, and it's a 3-1 count now to Bionia. Late in the ball game, late in the weekend series here, as Black will come to the plate way inside again. Bionia draws a walk for the second time in this contest, and we'll be back over at first. Runners on the corners now for Hoffman as he'll step in. Hoffman 1-for-3 with a triple, a couple of fly balls, and a walk in this contest. And now Hoffman will step into the batter's box here. And a step off here from Black. And Hoffman back into the box. Bionia at first, it's Jonathan Clough at third. Now the throw over to Bionia. He's back without even a slide that time. Reed will walk it back towards the mound, give it back to Black. It's kind of unconventional move at best that time from Black. Pitch coming and rolling towards second was Bayania. Now that ball up and outside to Hoffman. It's going to be a 1-0 count here as Bayania swipes second. So the 1-0 on its way from Black. And fouled right at the dugout for the Bulldogs off the front screen. And it's now 1-1. Mod on deck with Jorge De Los Santos in the hole here for the T-Birds. One away and runners at second and third for New Mexico, leading 7-4 here in the bottom half of the eighth inning. Ooh, swing and a miss that time. Way out in front of it was Hoffman. And it'll be a 1-2 count. Just pulled the chain on that one, didn't he? Little change in velocity. And Hoffman was fooled out in front of that one. Now a 1-2 count. Black to the plate. This ball slapped up the middle. Hoffman's got a single. It's going to score two runs here, as that'll make it a 9-4 contest here in the eighth inning. T-Birds up by five off the two-run single from Christian Hoffman. Been big in this game, probably the player of the game here today. Right up the middle through the wickets as Lachlan Mod will come in and get his AB here. And Black will miss high and outside with his first offering to Mod. Hoffman will take second base, and it's a 1-0 count here. Back in the scoring position are the T-Birds. And there's the pickoff move towards second. Hoffman dives back in, gets a hand on the bag before the tag could get to him. And Black will step back up on the rubber. An arm ready out in the bullpen, it looks like, for the Bulldogs. Also one for the T-Birds as we approach this ninth inning. We're in the bottom half of the eighth. T-Birds have put two across in the inning to up their lead to five runs. Up and into Mod near the chin. Not too close. And it's a 2-0 count. Tell you what, these old knees are aching now. Yeah, and I'm just an announcer. I would imagine how these players feel, huh? 2-0 count coming. Hoffman goes. He'll steal third on the swing and miss by Mod. And it will be a 2-1 count. So now a runner at third and one out here. 2-1 pitch coming to Lachlan Mod. Mod again, 1-for-3 on the day. Reached on an area. Blasts this one right up the middle. He's going to have another run batted in here as it's 10-4 T-Birds, which matches the winning score from the earlier action today. Mod with the RBI. So now, one away, and they will go to the bullpen. Will the Bulldogs? 10-4 here, bottom half of the eighth. T-Birds up six runs as De Los Santos will get a chance to step in. And we'll take a quick break as Drew Black will exit his appearance done for the day here for the Bulldogs. We'll be back in a few. And we're back again here. Ooh, getting a little shock from this board there as it's pretty wet out here. But we'll stick it out. It will be De Los Santos to the plate here for the T-Birds. New pitcher is going to be Evan Groh. Righty here, one away in the eighth. De Los Santos to the right side, foul. Out of play, 0-1. Now Groh to the dish again. He'll throw this one past the catcher. It'll be Maud heading down to second on the pass ball. And a 1-1 count here to De Los Santos. T-Birds trying to finish this one up. Almost 3 hours into it now, and a strike there called by the home plate umpire to De Los Santos. 1-2 now to Jorge De Los Santos here. One out, runner at second, and Lachlan Maud for the Thunderbirds already leading 10-4. This one will be a ball called and get by everybody. Yet again, 2-3 is Lachlan Maud. And a 2-2 count here. As Groh will head back to the bump. And please take your time, sir. It's not cold at all. No. So the 2-2 here with a runner at third and one away now for the T-Birds. Already up 6 runs in the bottom half of this eighth inning. De Los Santos. And a diving stop by Menchaca at short. It's going to be safe at first as that throw pulls Reed off the bag. Maud will score to make it 11-4 here.
Up to bat number 2, Pepe Contreras.
So Pepe Contreras will come to the plate here. As De Los Santos reaches on the error there. And now this one fouled straight back into the cinder block here from Contreras. And here comes the 0-1. This one will tail outside for a ball to Contreras. And it's a 1-1 count here. So you got De Los Santos at first base in an 11-4 ball game, bottom half of the eighth inning. T-Birds leading by 7, and at the plate is Contreras for the T-Birds. 2-1 as that one will miss from Groh as well. Contreras in this contest has grounded out, been hit by a pitch, walked, and laid down a really nice bunt to advance runners in the seventh inning. Now runner goes. De Los Santos will easily take second, and it's a 3-1 count now as that one way up high. And now this one is fouled off to the right side. It'll get out of play near the netting out down the right side, and it's a full count here. So Pepe Contreras steps back into the batter's box. One away and a full count here with a runner at second for New Mexico. That's a walk, and easily taking third now will be De Los Santos as Contreras will take first base. So that will bring up the shortstop and leadoff man, Luis Urias, here with runners on the corners. One out in the bottom half of the eighth. Urias in this one, 1 for 5. He's flown out, struck out, another fly out, a single and a fly out. Wow. Lots of appearances here at the plate today for Urias. Runner goes in Contreras, and again, no throw towards second. It's now runners at second and third with one away, and Urias at the plate. 1-0 count to him from Evan Groh. That one will catch the plate that time, about belt high on the outside part, and it's a 1-1 count. Now the 1-1 on the way, fouled down the left side by Urias, and it'll be a 1-2. 7-run T-Bird lead here in the bottom half of the eighth. They're still batting. They've pushed 4 across in the inning to take that 7-run lead. And with 2 on and 1 out, both runners in scoring position with Contreras at second and De Los Santos at third. That one will miss there as De Los Santos feigned a steal of home or was hoping maybe for a pass ball. Either way, just trying to rattle the pitcher that time. Groh must have worked. Gets a ball 2-2. Here comes the 2-2 way outside that time from Groh, and it'll be a full count. Now a walk issued on that payoff pitch as Urias will get a ticket to first on that one, and that'll bring up Brent Iredell. One out, bases are loaded. Coach out to speak with his pitcher Evan Groh here. In an 11-4 game, T-Bird still up 7 here with just one away. Groh will have to throw to last season's conference MVP in Iredell. Behind Iredell, doesn't get much better. Vlasic and Kloh, great hitters as well. And there's few people here, especially of the New Mexico Junior College Thunderbird fans and myself that, you know, a grand slam right here would be great. That would put an end to the day, and it is chilly out here. To 4, your score as Iredell steps back in. Evan Groh ready to deal. Right-handed thrower, right-handed hitter here. You can hear the chatter, and again, T-Bird's all out in the dugout standing and encouraging their teammates. Groh misses wildly outside with that first one. That's a 1-0 count here. Iredell on game 4 here is 1-for-4. He's grounded out twice and flown out, walked and singled. Everybody in the Bulldog dugout now kind of huddled up and near the seating area in there. Strike called as that one will catch the plate and just right about knee high to Iredell. 1-1. Getting the bases juiced here for Iredell. In a game, the A already lead 11-4. Bottom half of the eighth. That one will tail outside, be a ball called there. And 2-1 to count. And Iredell pops one up towards the right side. Looks like it'll get down safely out of play. It does, and 2-2 now becomes your count here. Just one out, bases are loaded. Bottom half of the eighth inning, T-Birds went up 2-0 in the second inning. It was tied up in the fourth by the Bulldogs with a two-run fourth. After that, T-Birds scored two in the fifth, sixth also. One in the seventh, got four across so far in the eighth as that ball misses badly, and we have another full count. Had several of those here in the later innings. As Groh will get a new ball from the umpire. So 11-4 is your score. The two runs that tied the game in the fourth inning for Clarendon, the only runs they had until the sixth and seventh as they pushed one across in each of those two innings. And that's where we stand. Full count here. Bases loaded. Groh to the plate. He'll walk Iredell. And that'll walk a run in here, making it 12-4. I believe that's ball game. Is that an eight-run rule, isn't it? Yes, it is. So, that'll do it here. 12-4, your final in game number four. The T-Birds sweep Clarendon on the weekend after the walk to Iredell. And that does it. 12-4, your score. Everybody getting in on the act this weekend is De Los Santos, Lachlan Maude, Travis Vlasic, Eric Bionia. Chloe had a really good weekend. I thought Urias had a great weekend. Hoffman had a really good weekend, too, here for the T-Birds. And pitching-wise, things starting to really come together for that pitching staff of the Thunderbirds and head coach Mike Robbins. His assistant, Laro Felix. And shortest post-game show ever happening right now. T-Birds sweep the weekend. They go to a 6-2 record in conference play. And that'll drop Clarendon down to 0-4. Mike Robbins and Laro Felix have it going. We are done here. We will see you again in about a week. And we'll have more T-Bird baseball to all the fans, including all the three grandmas of Lachlan Maude and all the grandmas out there watching. I'm Dusty Windham. We'll see you soon. Ah. Hey, can you just unplug it? It's shocking because it's wet.
Yeah.
Plug it first, though. When I touch it, it'll shock you. It won't shock you there. It's this one that's doing it.